J Matt is not your everyday lunch partner. He's all the way raw.
How are you going to say Black Lives Matter when the only reason you come out is when cops kill us and we don't come out when we kill ourselves? That's crazy, man.
He's all the way real.
The truth? You can't even handle the truth.
And most of all, he has his priorities right.
I want the Falcons and the Hawks to be my pallbearers at my funeral. That way they can let me down just one last time.
J-Mad gives it to you big.
Yeah, you need that real talk. Well, J-Mad, he got you right here doing God's work, bringing life after the collar. Hey, radio show, and he's doing it big. You just can't ignore J-Mad bringing you the word. Just holler at your boy. Hey, life after the collar with J-Mad.
Listening to Life After the Collar with your boy J-Man on Spreaker.com, iHeartRadio, Spotify, and all the other platforms that we are on. Even Alexa, that's right, Alexa can make it do what it do. Y'all, we're going to have a great show tonight. We are going to have a great show tonight. Thank y'all so much for hanging out with your boy J-Man. Grady, you know, let me tell you something, Doc. I'm in my feelings about them jokers. I'm truly in my feelings about those jokers. So it is what it is with them guys, man. It is what it is. Grady over here on Facebook Live was saying, you know, with these Falcons, we hurting right now. And that's the truth. Right now we are hurting. I'm trying to get myself situated. Here's why. So I had three misfunctions just before the show. This mic stand messed up on me. And then I left a very, 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 very important piece of gear at the spot that I DJed at last night. I had to DJ in Lithonia last night. Most people know me as J-Mad when I'm on my podcast and things like that. But last night, however.com.org and .net, last night I was under my DJ name, which is Mad Dog. It was a name I picked up from the military. I had some, well, I'm going to get into that. I'm going to get into some of that. I was getting ready to say something. Somebody said something, not sideways, but they was trying to question. But I want to dive into a little bit of that tonight. Hopefully you all are able to hear me clear. Spreaker, I think y'all are good over there. No issues over there. Facebook and TikTok, it looks like y'all good over there as well. Good evening, my friend. Just dropped in to show you some love. I appreciate that. Who is Sandra? Sandra? Marshall? Sinidra? Sinidra Williams? Sinidra Marshall? Sinidra Marshall, good to have you. Styling Diva, what's going on with you? Good to have you on the show. Aries, what's going on with you, love? Grady, what's up, man? Yogi, what's going on, love? I think that's everybody over here that chimed in already over here on Facebook. Good to have y'all on the show. So we're gonna have a great show tonight. Just gonna chill. We're gonna hang out. Tonight is one of those nights that I want to talk about. You didn't speak. Did you not see me say hello? I think I just spoke to you. Yogi, y'all, we're not going to do that tonight. Y'all, let's not do that. Kim, what's going on with you? Y'all, let's not. Look, I have a lot of different things going on. I do. You're hearing you clear. Okay, good. Thank you. Thank you so much. So here's what we're going to do. We're going to have one. Tonight is one of those nights that I wanted to do Friday. What's up, big dog? Jack, what's going on, man? tonight I want to do what I did. I tried to do Monday. I want to be able to have a conversation that is able to cover a lot of different topics. I'm not going to try to stay on one topic the whole night. I really want to. I'm trying to up my game on some things. I got some things that I'm working on, and I'm trying to up my game on certain things, and that's being able to, one, stay on topic. Because y'all are good about taking me off topic. Not y'all. When I see certain things in the chat room, I get sidetracked. So I'm going to try to cover at least three different topics tonight. I don't want to just stick with one topic. I want to cover three different topics. And they may go from, I have an idea of what the first topic is. Jacqueline, thank you so much. I'm new. I enjoy your, y'all do know that this is TikTok. I think I probably sung on maybe one TikTok, and that may have been a TikTok live. Can I sing? Yes. Am I that good? I don't think so. But a lot of those videos, I am really, really good at TikToking or lip syncing. I'm really good at lip syncing, so it looks like I'm singing. However.com.org and .net, I'm really not singing. I think I've only done two videos that I did with me live singing, and that was on a TikTok live. That was not on a video. So we're going to get into this show. We're going to start the show off by playing this one here. One of my favorite songs. Y'all know Luther is my dude. That's my dude there. So we're going to start the show off there here, and we're going to dive into it. Shout out to my son Jayon. Shout out to my eldest, my middle son Jamal, and shout out to Sammy, my youngest son. I appreciate you all. I love you on all three of you all, and Dad is gonna try to create a name for you. To my fellas out there that have, but we already understand. I don't like being that. This is not gonna work for me. Here's the thing. When we get in front of God, God is going to say, well, what did you do? What did you do? Why did you do this? You're not going to go to hell or heaven based off what somebody else did. I'm going to have to do it upstairs. Okay. The show, we're going to have some technical dis. We're going to be in and out. My thing is doing some things right now. Your thing is to answer to God about you, nobody else. Your thing is to answer God about you. Yo, you're listening to Life After the Collar with your boy J-Man on Spreaker.com, iHeartRadio, Spotify, and all the other platforms that we're on. Even Alexa, that's right. Alexa can make it do what it do. Holla at your boy. It's all gravy. Y'all, we're going to come back with a totally different conversation. All right? It's all good. It's all gravy. I'll holler.
So many things I've got to tell you, but I'm afraid I don't know how. 'Cause there's a possibility that you look at me differently, love. Ever since the first moment I spoke your name, from then on I knew that by you being in my life, things were destined to change. 'Cause love, so many people use your name. to know you, longing for your kiss,
for your kiss, touch, for your feel,
for your presence. Many nights I've cried from the things you do, felt like I could die from the thought of losing you. I know that you're real, with no doubts and no fears and no questions.
You're listening to Life After the Collar with your boy J-Mad on Spreaker.com, iHeartRadio, Spotify, and all the other platforms that we're on, even Alexa. That's right, Alexa can make it do what it do, baby, baby. Okay, let's do this. Let's do this. The switching conversations. I'm not doing that right now. But hee hee ha ha. I was on, and I think I talked about this earlier, or maybe Monday. I may have talked about it Monday. I don't know if I did or not. But how do I say this? I don't consider myself a relationship guru. I don't. By no means necessary. However, I know what I know. I'm going to share with you all So I started off by saying, I think I've talked about, so I was in, I'm in this chat group, in this Christian chat group, and I made a post about all women coming off, or I seen so many posts about women suggesting that all women are wife, what the Bible says, wife. So yesterday I was at work, and I was driving around town. I was driving around town. They still joking. I was driving around town, and clear as day, God started talking to me. Clear as day. Me and God, I love my relationship with God. Something happened first thing this morning. Something happened to me. Well, not happened to me. I was communicating with God, and he and I was joking so much. And I laugh every time I think about the conversation that we had. But here's what God told me. Here's what God shared with me. Ooh, my irritation just kicked in. Here's what God shared with me, and I wanted to share with you all. I shared it in a group that he told me, he asked me to share with. God said that women, he instructed me to say this. Ladies, you are not to appear to every man. You're not to appear to every man as a wife. Every man that comes across your path is not going to see you as a wife. Is not. He's not going to see you as a wife. He's not going to see you as a wife. The reason why every man is not supposed to see you as a wife is this. If every man see you as a wife, he is going to begin, that man, all men are going to covet. All men are going to covet something that's not theirs. If I see you as a wife, that person see you as a wife, that person see you as a wife, that person see you as the wife. Now the person that you, who's supposed to see you as a wife, he has all of the other dudes out here looking at you as a wife. And so now all of these dudes are going to start coming at you. Now, let me have a different conversation. Hey, Deanna, good to have you. Charlotte, what's going on with you? I'm ending the show at 8 o'clock tonight. I'm gonna have to end the show at 8 o'clock tonight. When it comes to who you are as a lady, be the best woman you can be so that the guy that comes around and you're holding, the Bible says a man that finds a wife finds a good thing. That thing is not you. The thing is something that you possess. You have something in your possession that only he needs. Not every man needs what you're carrying. Not every man needs what you're carrying. So stop wondering why all of these men aren't noticing you. That's what Curry's wife, when she was like, why aren't, you know, they all these women out here saying stuff to my husband, why aren't anybody saying, because we recognize who you are. We recognize you as his wife. It's a good thing, ladies. It is a good thing. It is a good thing that men aren't walking up to you. And you saying, well, why they not doing this? Why they ain't speaking to me? Why they ain't doing this? It's a good thing. Well, it's two things. Examine yourself, and if you're squared away, if you got everything in order, if they don't approach you, it is a good thing. Because they are not the one. Stop looking for a plethora of men to walk up to you and address you. The right man will. But when you all, and even from the guy's point of view too, when you put yourself out there like that, they're going to come at you like that. They're going to come at you like that. And I'm going to leave that conversation there. I'm going to leave that conversation. I got 9 minutes left. What do y'all want me to talk about in 9 minutes? If I don't hear anything in the next few minutes, I'm gonna cut it loose. For my own personal reasons, I'm gonna cut it off early tonight. I'm gonna cut it off early. We already having issues with the internet and stuff like that, and so I won't be irritated on different levels. I'm gonna end the show early. And I apologize to those that was wanting to hear more. But I'm on three times a week. Friday. You don't want to miss Friday's show. I have three special guests. Coming in from out of town that is going to hang out with me on Friday. If you're on TikTok, you're going to know who they are. If you're on TikTok, and mainly if you're following me, you know who they are, because I noticed that a lot of my followers are followers of these people. I do duets with them, have done several duets with them, and I have been drawn to them, and I want to share my life with them. Louisville, okay, here we go. There we go. That's a good topic. Cherry Boy, 1967. Louisville grand jury finding. Very disappointed. Very disappointed in that outcome, because no one is really being charged with her death. They're only being charged with what the misconduct that happened. You did something wrong. You did something bad. Forget about killing her. Miss Jackson 881 saw it coming from a mile away. I knew, even when they started two or three days ago, when they started putting up the barriers around the courthouses and things like that, I already knew what the outcome was. I have some things that I want to say about that whole situation. Not just that situation, but them killing us. I have an issue with black cops right now. I have a huge issue with black cops right now. Good cops. I have a huge issue with good cops. I have officially put all cops, and I have great cop friends. Matter of fact, the beautiful lady, my sis that was on my TikTok live where I was DJing, her husband, Ty, her husband is a cop. I'm not going to say which force he's on, but her husband is a cop. Really good friends. And I was doing 4th of July, I was able to sit with a whole bunch of cops, and they gave me their version of things. But I'm going to have to put it this way. I have officially put all cops in the same category now. I understand that we have good cops. I understand we have bad cops. But the problem is the good cops are not speaking up. That's the problem. The good cops are not speaking up, which puts you in the same. We put you in the same category as the black bad cops. It puts you in the same exact category because you're keeping your mouth closed. And you're allowing this stuff to keep happening. Now, I want everybody to understand what's going on is nothing new. Them killing us is not anything new. This stuff didn't just happen. This stuff did not just start. This has been going on since after they freed the slaves. And they came up with all of these rules and regulations. If you didn't know how to read, if you didn't know how to do this, if you didn't have land, if you didn't have this, you was able to be arrested. They was dragging us behind cars and horses and stuff back way back then in slavery days. The cops. This is nothing new. The only difference is that we have cameras now. And the white folks that didn't believe that they were doing that now see it. That's the only difference. That's why the white people that out protesting, they did not believe it was happening. Now they see it. Now it's it. Thank you, Jackie. I will. So that's it. So that stuff there, that stuff right there. I saw it come. I knew nothing was going to come of it. I knew they was going to get the guy that was already fired because he's no longer covered by. He's no longer covered. When he got fired, he was no longer covered by the association. He was no longer covered by the union. So, and I'm at a point where I don't even trust politicians, even though I want to be one. Even though I want to be one. Let me help you all out. I'm going to say this before I get offline. 3 minutes. I got 3 minutes and I'm out of here. I have 3 minutes and I'm out of here. Voting does not change anything. Voting does not change anything. We put a whole black president in office and it didn't change anything. Matter of fact, what it did was showcase racism at its finest. So the question is, well, what changes things? You holding those in office accountable. Forget about election day. Because whoever in office is in office. But the ones that are in office, start holding them accountable. That's what changes things. I know the Democrats want us to believe right now, you got to vote. If you want change, you got to vote. No, y'all assholes has been. It ain't even 8 o'clock. I'm sorry. Forgive me. If y'all kids was up, I apologize. These politicians has been in office, Republican and Democrat, has been in office running things all of these years. And we're still here in 2020. We're still here in 2020. Voting is not going to change anything. Holding politicians accountable is the thing that changes things. November the 3rd is needed. But what's going to need to happen is November the 4th and on. That's what needs to happen. Hey, thank y'all so much for hanging out with me tonight. I appreciate y'all. Love y'all. May God bless y'all. May God keep you. It is what it is. I'm going to holler at y'all next time. I'll holler.
Need that real talk? Well, J Mad, he got ya right here doing God's work, bringing life after the collar. Hey, radio show, and he's doing it big. You just can't ignore J Mad bringing you the word. Just holler at your boy. Hey, life after the collar with J Mad.
No. not your everyday lunch partner. He's all the way raw.
How are you going to say Black Lives Matter when the only reason you come out is when cops kill us and we don't come out when we kill ourselves? That's crazy, man.
He's all the way real.
The truth? You can't even handle the truth.
And most of all, he has his priorities right.
I want the Falcons and the Hawks to be my pallbearers at my funeral. That way they can let me down just one last time.
J-Mad gives it to you big.